Welcome to my Paris vlog. The first day. So I decided that I really wanted to go travel again because it's been a very long time due to COVID and everything. And January, everything just aligned, my plans, my schedule and everything, so I just figured I'd go and do it. Just figured I'd go somewhere. And there were many places that I wanted to visit, but I figured I wouldn't go too far, so I was figuring maybe Germany, maybe Belgium or something like that, but then I figured, you know, Paris, there's a lot of stuff that I still wanted to see there, and I never got to see. So we arrive at the train station, which is really nice. After that, we went to our hotel, got rid of all the bags, and we went back with the subway to the Sacré-Cœur, which is like the basilisk or church or whatever it is that is like high up on the mountain, on the hill in the city. You can like see it from the Eiffel Tower and whatever. And then we just took some pictures, took some videos around. I posted some pictures on Instagram as well while we were there. And luckily there was still a lot of Christmas decoration around, which was actually really nice to see as well, even though this is like a couple weeks actually after Christmas, but still it's fun to see with all the lights and everything still there. So yeah, we also bought like both of us a beret, so we were taking pictures and all that, just, you know, pretending to be French and everything, because that's part of it. And after we went inside, had a look around, which was really amazing to see, we walked down through the park, pretty much it's at the front of the Sacré-Cœur, walked back down with just an amazing view of the city. Then we decided to walk along the city streets a little bit more, just to look around. After that, we went back to the hotel, looked for some place to eat nearby, found this amazing restaurant, and enjoyed it very much before heading back to our room. Which was, you know, it was a budget hotel, and it sure was budget. So day two, enjoying the amazing view from our hotel. Sadly, the first few days were very rainy, like the weather was absolutely not that great the first 2 days specifically, so we pretty much just decided to walk around this day, and you know, it was raining, so we made the best of it that we could. First, we went to the Eiffel Tower, we walked around a little bit, then we had breakfast at a local patisserie, where we had, you know, I had a cappuccino, my chocolate croissant, and then from the Eiffel Tower, we walked a little bit further. So across the Eiffel Tower, you have the Musée de l'Homme, where you also have a Palais de Chaillot, and that's just an amazing place to take videos from, to like look around and look at the Eiffel Tower. That's where most people usually go when they want to have a picture of themselves with the Eiffel Tower. We were pretty much just circling the Eiffel Tower for a bit before going there, and it was very interesting to go there. I mean, this is like the most touristy part of Paris. This is where all the people come for. So it was just nice to also go there and look around, see what is, you know, up there. Checked out some butts. So yeah, I have like a whole album of like pictures of me with the Eiffel Tower, just from different angles and everything. We walked up a little bit onto the stairs, and from there on we were heading towards the Arc de Triomphe. Of course, we had a little break, stopped to have a bit of a drink at a nearby cafe. The weather was becoming, you know, a little bit more bearable towards this part of the day. It wasn't that great still, but, you know, it didn't rain as much as it had the night before. So when we finished our beverages, we decided to continue onwards towards the Arc de Triomphe, which is where we're at next, which thankfully was free for us because we're European citizens and we're younger than like 26 year olds, which I thought was like the age where they cut you off. So you can go to a lot of stuff for free. And this is one of those things that you get to go to for free. And I definitely recommend going to the Arc de Triomphe. I mean, it has an amazing view. Also because of the fact that it is built on a hill, so you have an amazing view, because not only is it a tall structure, it's also up on a hill. So, you know, you have an amazing view. We decided to go here instead of the Eiffel Tower, because the Eiffel Tower was under construction, so you could only go to the halfway platform and not all the way to the top. And the Eiffel Tower is not free. You have to pay like 13 bucks for it, which isn't that expensive, but the price didn't become less because it was under construction, so I figured, I'd rather just go for free to the Arc de Triomphe, be at about the same height, rather than go to the Eiffel Tower. You want a picture with the Eiffel Tower anyways, you don't want like a picture of you on the Eiffel Tower, like nobody would know that you're on the Eiffel Tower. So here I decided to take some video of our surroundings, what it looked like, yeah, just amazing views. After having gone to the Arc de Triomphe, we decided to walk down the Champs-Élysées. And we pretty much walked until the Franklin D. Roosevelt subway station, like right before you get to the park, because we just wanted to eat something. So we didn't follow it all the way towards Place de la Concorde, which was, you know, also something that I wanted to see. But, you know, Paris is huge, you don't get to see everything, you have to choose. So we did go into Louis Vuitton, which, you know, is an amazing store. We went inside a huge Sephora where we could actually afford stuff, because, you know, Sephora isn't really that expensive. And from there we then walked to this park that I found online, Parc Monceau, or Monceau, or Monceau, or however you may pronounce it. Which is this very nice looking park where you're already like walking through, you know, very evidently upscale Parisian apartments, which is, you know, understandable. This is like right around the corner from like the upper class shopping district. So of course this is like what you're going to be next to or surrounding. It's pretty much the same with like New York. Or anywhere in any city really, but you know, it's very evident that this is upscale. So we went to the park, which was honestly just so awesome because, you know, a rich people park, how amazing. There are all these statues and busts and stuff like that around, which was really cool to see. They also had like a fairy village, I don't know what to call it, like leprechaun village, which was very fun for the kids to watch. It reminded me a lot of San Francisco Palace of the Fine Arts, because they also have a lot of that stuff going on. And after that, we went back and actually dined at the same restaurant again. Day three, we went to the Louvre, or Louvre, whatever you want to pronounce it as. which is free as well for us European citizens below the age of 26. So, of course, you gotta go there. But even then, when you go to Paris, you have to go to the Louvre. Why else were you there? And of course, you have to go see the Mona Lisa, you know? So yeah, I personally, in art, there's two things that I really like, and it's realistic landscapes, as in paintings, and then there is statues. I don't know why, but I love statues, especially like the Greek and Roman statues. So for instance, this one, Nike, to me, that is like the crème de la crème, honestly. I love that. To me, that is like a thing where I'm in awe, like, oh my god, I saw the statue of Nike. That to me was like way more impressive. And of course, the Golden Room, as I like to call it, was awesome as well. There's a lot of gold and stuff and jewelry, which I love to see. They also had a part of the museum where you get to see pretty much like different styles of upscale living, so like furniture and tapestries and you name it, whatever they had it of, like, well, expensive and very nice furniture, which is also just awesome to see. I love to just look at the big rooms, at the furniture, the jewelry, the nice paintings, the intricate statues. Those are like things that I just love to see. As you can see, I've videoed a lot of ceilings and a lot of golden rooms, because that's my style. I love that. That's very nice. It's never too much. You can always use more gold in your room. More velvet chairs, more exotic plants. And then we have this main part of the building where you have, like, the ground floor and the lower part is just filled with these statues, and I love it. It looks amazing. I mean, of course, the museum itself looks, you know, so impressive, so nice. Just looking at the museum itself is already so very interesting. But then all these statues, I just love it. And then to look at them and then ask yourself, oh, what ancient Greek tale is this one about? And try and guess and see if you're correct. That's super fun to me. So after we were done with that, I mean, we spent several hours in the museum, which is understandable because it is huge. I bet you can spend an entire day at it if you're interested in, like, watching everything. I personally like the nice things very much, and, you know, the more basic historic artifacts are not per se my thing. After that, we decided to walk towards the Notre Dame. Reason being, you know, wanted to see it, look at it. Of course, you cannot go inside it right now, but at least I wanted to have seen it from the outside. Also, supposedly walking past the Seine is, like, you know, very nice to see. Usually there's a lot of artists and painters. Today that was not. There was just a lot of people selling books and stuff. But of course, all the books were in French, so not really interested in that because I don't speak or read French, so. But yeah, had a look around a bit, but interestingly, across the Notre Dame, there is this store, and it is an amazing store, okay? It is called Shakespeare and Company, and you have to go there, okay? The shop looks so cute from the outside, so cute from the inside, and the prices are really good. I mean, for the readers among us, you know, bookdepository.com, which is an amazing website, has very cheap books, and no shipping costs, so that's amazing. They had books which were even cheaper than they were at Book Depository, so I was just like flabbergasted by it, so of course I bought a bunch of books again, and a tote bag, which was a really nice tote bag. And from there we just walked a little bit further, decided, you know, let's just look around a bit, decide where we want to have dinner. So we walked all the way up to the Pantheon, but by the time we got there, it's later, it was closed. I don't know actually if you need tickets to even go inside, but it was very obviously closed. So yeah, we had dinner right by the Pantheon. Then when we came out, you know, it was dark. Everything's lit up with these blue lights. The Eiffel Tower was sparkling, and that was just a beautiful, you know, close to our day. Day four is also a day of a lot of walking, not gonna lie. We went to Cemetery du Père Lachaise, which is a very famous cemetery, apparently. I was told so by other people to go and visit it. It was very interesting to see, walk around. Sadly, once again, the weather wasn't too great. I mean, it was just cloudy at least, and later it did got better in the day. But yeah, once again, we had amazing views. It was very interesting to see, you know, it's a very nice cemetery. Not even because the graves are so big and fancy and everything. It's also just very interesting to walk around, how things are spaced, how old certain graves are. Clearly still very active, as you can still see quite new additions and everything. From there, we walked back into town, heading towards Place de la Bastille. And I actually totally forgot, but I apparently matched up that the day we would get there would be the day of the market. So I was like, oh wow, I totally forgot that I made sure that we would get to see the market when we get there. So that was great. Walked around a bit. I mean, it's very interesting right there. This is like the part of the town that is like so lively, so much to see. There's a lot of stuff we saw. We went to Place des Vosges, which was also an amazing part. It's a park, as you can see. Yeah, and that was just very fun to see as well. It was very nice. I mean, everything here is very upscale, very classy, very nice and good looking. So it was very fun to walk around here. The only thing that's a bit disappointing is that on Google Maps, it sometimes recommends certain streets, telling you, oh, this is an interesting street. 9 out of 10 times, it is not. Okay, I don't know what's up with Google Maps, but a lot of those streets that are supposedly very fun to see are not fun at all. So here we walked past Rue de Rivoli, which is one of those main streets again. We went past the Tour Saint-Jacques. We walked, you know, past City House. And it was also in the street that we noticed that there were a lot of Dutch stores. There was the Hema, C&A. We walked past a church, which I found pretty interesting, so I decided to head in, see what's in there. And then we made it about the furthest that we possibly could. So it's called Place Vendôme, where you have this very large thing. Later we went to the catacombs. That was the final thing that we did. We've already had dinner at that point and just decided to close off the night with one more drink. And then it's day five, our final day. So we went to Hotel des Invalides, which is it's a lot of things. It's several museums in there, but we got the ticket that was entrance to the main museum, which is the Army Museum, and then on the other side of the building, you have the tomb of Napoleon, which you can see. And I've always wanted to go there. I've wanted to go there for a very long time, which was the main reason why we went there. Morning was kind of rough, not gonna lie. There were these, like, French guys over there, and they were like, yeah, you want to visit the museum? Yeah, we were like 10 minutes early, okay? And it was raining. And they told us, no, you cannot enter until it's like exactly 10. So we had to wait outside in the rain, just standing there. And I'm like, okay, don't show up early, I guess. After that, we went inside, looked around the building. I mean, everything was very interesting and nice to see in the Army Museum. But yeah, this was also like a very rough morning. I mean, that bed that we were like sleeping in, it was just killing me. Like, my arms hurt so much, my neck hurt so much, everything just hurt at this day because we just been walking for 5 days and then sleep is just terrible. So I was actually really looking forward to going back in the train that night so I could try and sleep. So we pretty much done everything that I had researched, everything that I wanted to do, everything that seemed interesting. And I mean, there's still a lot of stuff, you know, because Paris is a huge city. There are still things that I want to see and do and go to, but everything is just very far apart of each other. So after we had gone to the grave of Napoleon, I still really wanted to go to Galeries Lafayette, which is a store and it sells like anything you can possibly imagine. It's huge and it's several stores together. It's behind the opera, Palais Garnier. Which is, you know, already a very interesting neighborhood to see. We went up there, looked around. I mean, it's just an amazing looking store, honestly. This is also like the big one, the most interesting one. Looked around, took some video, went to the terrace because I researched beforehand that apparently they had a terrace and you could go all the way to the top and take a video. And I was like, okay, that's awesome. And then we decided it was lunchtime, so we went back out, walked a little bit down the street, found a nice and simple pizzeria, had a pizza there, and then we figured, well, you know, I've seen everything I wanted to see, is there anything left? Because there was a lot still left on my list, but, you know, we were reaching the end of the day, we were very tired, and I wasn't feeling like having to look up the right subway, going to exactly the station where I wanted to go to still see the last few things, so. So we pretty much decided to walk back to a local subway station, and then we went back, got our bags, and then we went to the train station, still having like 2 hours to spare. We ate there, and then that was it. That was my trip in Paris. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe.